हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई वांट टू डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 2.2 ऑफ चैप्टर 6 लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। बिफोर स्टार्ट द एक्सरसाइज आई वांट टू डिस्कस द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 6.2। फर्स्टली आई वांट टू डिस्कस द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ट्रावर्सल लाइन, अ लाइन विच इंटरसेक्ट टू और मोर गिवन लाइन्स इन डिस्टिंक्ट पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड ट्रावर्सल ऑफ द गिवन लाइन। इन दिस डायग्राम देर आर टू लाइन्स एल एंड एम एंड पी इज ए ट्रावर्सल लाइन बिकॉज लाइन पी intersect L and M are two points at A. This point is represented is A and this point is represent point B. Line P is called traversal line because line P intersect L and M and two points A and B. Now in this diagram there are total 8 angles. This is angle 1, this is angle 2, this is angle 3, this is angle 4, this is angle 5, this is angle 6, this is angle 7, this is angle 8. Angle 3, 4, 5, 6 are called interior angles. I repeat, angle 3, 4, 5, 6 are called interior angles. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, angle 8 are called exterior angles. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, angle 8 are called exterior angles. Corresponding angles angle 1 and angle 6. Corresponding angle are that angles in which one angle is exterior and one angle is interior and on the same sides. Angle 1 is exterior, angle 6 is interior, therefore angle 1 and angle 6 are corresponding angles. Angle 4 and angle 8, these are two corresponding angles, angle 4 and angle 8, angle 1 and angle 6. Angle 2 and angle 5 are also corresponding angles. Angle 3 and angle 7 are also corresponding angles. I repeat, corresponding angles are angle 1 and angle 6, angle 4 and angle 8, angle 2 and angle 5, angle 3 and angle 7 are corresponding angles. Alternate interior angles. Angle 3 and angle 6 are alternate interior angles. Angle 3 and angle 6 are alternate interior angles. Angle 4 and angle 5 are alternate interior angles. Alternate exterior angles. Angle 1 and angle 7 are alternate exterior angles. Angle 2 and angle 8 are alternate exterior angles. Interior angle on the same side. 4 and angle 6 are interior angles on the same side because this is side this. And angle 3 and angle 5 interior angle on the same side or consecutive angles. Angle 4 and angle 6, these are angles are also called co-interior angles. Angle 3 and angle 5 are also called co-interior angles. In this diagram, you can see that AB and CD are two parallel lines and T is a traversal line which intersect at AB and CD at a points P and Q. This is angle 1, this is angle 2, this is angle 3, this is angle 4, this is angle 5, this is angle 6, this is angle 7, this is angle 8. Now, important relations. Important relations. If two lines are parallel, then alternate interior angles are equal. If suppose AB parallel CD, then alternate interior angles are equal, then angle 3 equal to angle 5 and angle 2 equal to angle 8. If two lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are equal. If AB parallel CD, then angle 1 equal to angle 5 and angle 2 equal to angle 6. Angle 4 equal to angle 8, angle 3 equal to angle 7. If two lines are parallel, then sum of interior angle on the same side is supplementary, that is 180. If AB parallel CD, then sum of angle 2 plus 5 equal to 180 and angle 3 and angle 8 is 180. Now converse of important relations. Converse of important relation is if alternate interior angles are equal, then two lines are parallel. If angle 3 equal to angle 5, then we can say that AB parallel CD. Or if we have given angle 2 equal to angle 8, we can see that AB parallel CD. If corresponding angles are equal, then two lines are parallel. If we have given angle 1 equal to angle 5, then AB parallel CD. If we have given angle 2 equal to angle 6, then AB parallel CD. If we have given angle 4 equal to angle 8, then AB parallel CD. Means if we have given corresponding angles are equal, then two lines are parallel. If the sum of interior angle on the same side of the transversal is 180, then two lines are parallel. If the we have given the sum of two angle 2 plus angle 5 is 180, then AB parallel CD. If we have given angle 3 plus angle 8 equal to 180, then AB parallel CD. These are the converse of important relations. Now exercise 6.2, question number 1. In the given figure, find the values of x and y and then show that AB parallel CD. In this question, we have to find the value of x and y and we have to prove that AB parallel CD. Now angle x, this angle represent angle x, this angle represent angle 50 degree. These two angles are on the line this, therefore x plus 50 degree equal to 180 degree. X equal to 180 degree minus 50 degree. 180 degree minus 50 degree, we get 130 degree. X equal to 130 degree. Now, Y equal to 130 degree. Y equal to 130 degree, the vertical opposite angle. These two angles are vertically opposite angle. Now, we have angle X equal to angle Y equal to 130 degree. Angle X equal to angle Y equal to 130 degree. But these two angles are alternate interior angles. We know that if alternate interior angles are equal, then two lines are parallel. Here angle x, angle y are alternate interior angle and is equal to 130 degree, therefore AB parallel CD. Question number 2. In the given figure, if AB parallel CD, CD parallel EF and angle y ratio z equal to 3:7, we have to find the value of x. In this figure, AB parallel CD, CD parallel EF, angle Y ratio, angle Z equal to 3:7, we have to find the value of X. Now, we are given that AB parallel CD and CD parallel EF, therefore, we can conclude that AB parallel CD, CD parallel EF, these lines are parallel to each other, we can say that, and angle Y ratio Z equal to 3:7. Therefore, let angle y equal to 3a, z equal to 7. Let this is equation number 1. Now, AB parallel EF. AB parallel EF. Therefore, angle x equal to z. Angle x equal to angle z. Because these two are alternate interior angle. Because we have given AB parallel EF. Angle x equal to angle z, alternate interior angles. But z equal to 7a. Z equal to 7a. Put z equal to 7a in this. Therefore, we have x equal to 7a. Let this is equation number 2. Now, AB parallel CD. We have given AB parallel CD. Therefore, angle x plus y equal to 180. Angle x plus y equal to 180 degree. Because we know that if two lines are parallel, then sum of interior angle on the same side is 180. Therefore, angle x plus y equal to 180. Put x equal to 7a, y equal to 3a. 7a plus 3a equal to 180 degree. 7 plus 3, 10a equal to 180 degree. A equal to 180 upon 10. 0 with 0 cancel. A equal to 18 degree. Now we have y equal to 3a. 3a meaning 3 multiply a. A is given 18 degree. 3 multiply 18, 54 degree. Now we have x plus y equal to 180. Y we have 154. Therefore put y equal to 54 degree. X plus 54 degree equal to 180, X equal to 180 minus 54, X equal to 126 degree, means angle X equal to 126 degree. Question number 3. In the given figure, if AB parallel CD, EF perpendicular CD, in the given figure AB parallel CD, EF perpendicular CD, means this angle is 90 degree, and angle GED equal to 126, GED means this angle is 126 degree. We have given, find angle AGE, AGE, we have to find this angle, AGE, and GEF, GEF, we have to find this angle, GEF, and FGE, F GE. We have to find this angle. Now angle GED equal to 126. GED means this angle is 126 degree. We have given. We can write angle GED as GEF plus FED. GEF plus FED. GEF as it is, FED we have given 90 degree. So put FED equal to 90 degree equal to 126. GEF equal to 126 minus 90 degree. GEF equal to 36 degree. Means GEF is 36. This angle is 36 degree. Now AB parallel CD we have given. Therefore angle AGE equal to GED, alternate interior angle. AGE means this angle. And GED means this angle. Alternate interior angles. AGE, we have given GED equal to 126, therefore AGE equal to 126. Now angle AGE plus FGE equal to 180 degree, linear pair. AGE, AGE means this angle, FGE means this angle, are on the same line AB, therefore sum of these angles is 180 degree. AGE 126 plus FGE equal to 180. Therefore angle FGE equal to 180 minus 126 degree. Therefore angle FGE equal to 54 degree. 54 degree is your required answer. Now question number 4 is, in the given figure, if PQ parallel ST, angle PQR equal to 110, angle RST equal to 130 degree, find angle QRS. In the given figure, we have given angle PQR 110 degree, angle RST 130 degree and PQ parallel ST. Hint, draw a line parallel to ST through point R. In this question, we have to do the construction. We need to draw a line RX that is parallel to the line ST. Now draw line RX that is parallel to ST. Now RX parallel ST. Therefore, angle RST, RST plus SRX equal to 180. We know that angles on the same side are supplementary. We have given angle RST is 130 degree, SRX equal to 180 degree, SRX equal to 180 minus 130 degree, SRX equal to 180 minus 130, we get 50 degree, therefore SRX equal to 50 degree, SRX means this angle is 50 degree. Now PQ parallel ST, PQ parallel ST and ST parallel RX, ST parallel RX by construction, PQ parallel ST we have given from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, PQ parallel RX, PQ parallel RX. Now PQ parallel RX, therefore angle PQR equal to angle QRX means this angle equal to this angle, because these two angles are alternate interior angle. I repeat, PQ parallel RX, therefore angle PQR, this angle, angle QRX means this angle. These two angles are alternate interior angles. PQR equal to 110. We can write QRX as QRS plus SRX. 110 as it is, QRS SRX is 50 degree. 110 minus 50 degree equal to QRS. 110 minus 50 degree we get 60 degree. Therefore angle QRS equal to 60 degree is your required answer. Question number 5 is, in the given figure AB parallel CD and angle APQ is 50 degree. We have given AB parallel CD and angle APQ is 50 degree and angle PRD. PRD is 127 degree. Find X and Y. Find X and Y. We have given AB parallel CD and angle APQ is 50 degree and PRD is 127 degree. We have to find the value of X and Y. Now AB parallel CD and PQ is transversal. AB parallel CD and let PQ is transversal. Therefore angle APQ equal to PQR, because these two angles are alternate interior angles. Therefore 50 degree equal to X, because if two lines are parallel then alternate interior angles are equal. Therefore 50 degree equal to X. Now AB parallel CD, AB parallel CD and PR is transversal, and PR is transversal. Therefore, APR angle APR equal to angle PRD, PRD, because these two angles are alternate interior angle. APR this angle, PRD means this angle. We can write APR angle is APQ plus QPR, APQ APQ plus QPR equal to angle PRD 50 degree plus. We have given AQPR is Y, so put angle QPR is Y equal to 127 degree. So Y equal to 127 degree minus 50 degree, 127 minus 50 degree, we have Y equal to 77 degree. So Y equal to 77 degree. Thank you.